Hi, good morning, guys. So, there was a case in the Supreme Court. You can take it as a case study, okay? So, what is the West Bengal Union of India and the Supreme Court, okay? So, basically, 3 to 4 questions can be arise from this one. So, the Section 6, we are just concentrating on Section 6, okay? So, in general cases, what happen? The state government, the CBI, okay? CBI made from Delhi Special Police Establishments Act 1946, okay? So, CBI has to take the consent from the respective state, okay? But a state has also a power to say yes or no, give consent or no, okay? But the now the situation came, if every state say that we do not allow CBI to study the case in our state, okay? So what will happen? Like, there is a BJP, okay, in the center. There are many Congress ruled state or anti BJP government. So they will say, we will not allow the CBI to study the cases in our state, respective state. What will happen? That's the where the Section 6 come. Section 6 say that CBI has the power to take any case of any Indian territory, any Indian administration territory, okay? God is Section 6, that's why it is so important. And they do not need of consent from respective state or union territory, okay? Got it? So now the second question arises, who is the more powerful, CBC or CBI? If the case is related to corruption cases, okay? If the case is from corruption cases, then CBC has more powerful, okay? Central Vigilance Commission, they have more power than the CBI, and even they overtook the CBI case, okay? But in general cases, CBI if it is non-corruption cases, then CBI handle it, okay? But when it related to corruption, economics, scams, then it is totally CBC. It come under CBC, okay? Got it? And the both are the established from this one, Delhi Special Establishment for CV. Okay, you have got it. Okay, that's great. Yeah.